Hi viewers, in today's lecture we're going to discuss on inheritance concept in Python application programming. So we are having five different types of inheritance that are said to be single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance and hybrid inheritance. So before going to this particular types, we will understand what is said to be inheritance. Inheritance is said to be the properties of base class will be accessed by the derived class. Base class we can able to tell parent class, in other word, and derived class we can able to tell child class. So child class or derived class can access the properties of base class or parent class. So this is the basic structure of inheritance. So with use of this common understanding, we will enter into the types of inheritance so that you can able to understand what is the difference between each and every type. Okay. So first we will start with single inheritance. So single inheritance having a single base class and single derived class. So how we are accessing the base class property in derived class in single inheritance, we will check it out with use of this particular program. So here we are having our class name as base. So our class name is base. So inside the class base, we are having the method named as base underscore method. So we are having base inside the base class, we are having base underscore method. So inside the method, we are just displaying a statement. What is the statement we are displaying? Inside base class method, we are displaying as a output statement. So this is our base class. Next to that, we are writing the derived class. So class derived, then what I am giving? I am giving open parenthesis, then base class I am giving. So what is the base class name? Our base class name is base. So in the derived class, we are inheriting the base class, so that we have to give open parenthesis base close parenthesis colon. So this is the way we can able to access the base class properties or inherit the base class in the derived class. Okay, so derived open parenthesis base class name close parenthesis colon. So this is the way we can able to access the base class in derived class. In Java programming, we will use extends keyword to make this particular activity. So in C++ programming, we are using double colon so that we can able to access the base class properties in the derived class. But in Python programming, you can give the base class name in open and close parenthesis when you are creating the derived class, so that the base class properties will be accessed by the derived class. Okay. So inside the derived class, what we are doing, we are just writing the derived class method, that is said to be derived underscore method. So inside the method, we are just giving inside derived class method. So this is the statement we are just displaying inside the derived class method. So we created the base class and we created the derived class. Now what we are doing, we are just creating the object for the derived class. So our object name is D. So we are creating object for the derived class. So with use of derived class object, we can able to access the base class method as well as derived class method. As I told, when we are accessing the properties of base class with use of derived class, so what we can able to do, we can able to create a single object for derived class. With use of that object, we can able to access the base class method as well as derived class method. Our base class method name is base underscore method and our derived class method name is derived underscore method. So both the methods I am accessing with use of single object, that is object for derived class. So that is the beauty of single inheritance. Single inheritance mean by with use of single base class and single derived class, we can able to run this show. And for the derived class, we have to create the object. With use of derived class object, we can able to access the base class properties as well as derived class properties. Okay, now let's move for multi-level inheritance. So multi-level inheritance mean by what? There is a base class, down to that a derived class, down to that one more derived class, like that we may have n number of derived classes. So it's like a ladder. So one by one we are having. So first we are having a base class, down to that we are having derived class, down to that another derived class, like that. So the topmost class what we are having, that is said to be most base class, and the last class what we are having, the ending class, that we are telling us most derived class. In between, a list of classes will be there. So how we are doing this particular program, let's see. So here we are having the base class name as base. Inside that, the same method only, whatever the method I wrote in the previous example, same method only I'm repeating for understanding purpose. So here base underscore method we are having. So inside base underscore method, what we are doing, we are just printing inside base class method. We are just printing this particular print statement inside the base class. Then I am creating a derived class. This is my derived one. So derived one is my first derived class. So that will inherit the base class. My base class name is base. So I am just putting inside the open and close parenthesis so that the base class will be inherited by the derived one. So inside derived one, what we are having, derived one underscore method. So inside that, we are just displaying a statement as inside derived one class method. So this will be displayed when we are calling the derived one method. Next to that, I am writing derived two. So derived two class, what happens? Derived two class extends the derived one class. Mean by the derived one class properties will be accessed by derived two class. So derived two underscore method we are having. So in this particular derived two class, we are having a method named as derived two underscore method that will display inside derived two class method. Okay. So we are having three classes. So one class will extend another class like that. It's like a chain link. So this type of chain link is said to be multi-level inheritance. So base class will be inherited by the derived one. Derived one will be inherited by the derived two. So that's why I'm telling that is a chain link between all the classes. Now for which class we have to create the object? We have to create the object for the most derived class. So here most derived class is the last class that is said to be derived two. Okay, so derived two, we have to create object. With use of derived two object, we can able to access the base class method as well as derived one method as well as derived two method. Okay, so all the three methods we can able to access with use of the most derived class object. So our object name is D. I am creating for derived two. So with use of this object D, I am accessing the base class method that is said to be base underscore method. Then I am just accessing derived one underscore method, and then I am accessing derived two underscore method. So three methods I am accessing with use of single object. So that is the beauty of multi-level inheritance. Okay. So I hope you understand multi-level inheritance. There is a chain link. The base class will be accessed by the derived one. Derived one is accessed by derived two. So derived two, we are creating object with use of the derived two object. We are accessing the base class method, derived one method, and derived two method. Okay. So let's move for the next inheritance, that is said to be multiple inheritance. So when we are coming to multiple inheritance, that will be said to be multiple base classes under single derived class, that is said to be multiple inheritance. So when we are having multiple base class, we have to inherit all the base classes in the single derived class. So that will be a fully object oriented programming language. If it supports multiple inheritance, then we can tell the particular programming language is fully object oriented programming language. Java is a semi object oriented programming language because Java will not support multiple inheritance. We are achieving multiple inheritance with use of interface, but it will not support like our C++ or Python programming. You can see the program how we are doing the multiple inheritance in Python programming now. So what I am doing, I am just creating three different base classes. Base one is my first base class, base two is my second base class, and base three is my third base class. Inside base one, what we are having, base one underscore method we are having. So inside the method, inside base one class method, we are printing as a statement. So base two class, what we are having, a method named as base two underscore method. So inside the method, what we are displaying, inside base two class method we are displaying. So next to that, base three, inside that we are having a method named as base 3 underscore method, and inside that we are just displaying inside base 3 class method. So three classes we created, three different base classes we created, and three different methods inside each and every base class, and finally we are creating the derived class. So derived class I am creating that will inherit all the three base classes. How I am inheriting all the three? I am giving base 1 comma base 2 comma base 3. So like that I am accessing all the three base classes in the single derived class. Okay. So now inside the derived class, what I'm doing, I'm just making a derived class method that is said to be derived underscore method. Inside the derived class method, what I'm displaying inside the derived class method, I'm displaying as a statement. Okay. So what we done until this, we created three base classes and a single derived class. In that single derived class, we are inheriting all the three base classes. Okay. Now, for which class I have to create object? I have to create object for the derived class. So when I'm creating object for the derived class, so the object name is D. With use of D, I can able to access the first base class method and second base class method as well as third base class method, and at last we can able to access the derived class method. So all the four methods I can able to access with use of the single object that is created for the derived class. Okay, so this is the beauty of multiple inheritance. Okay, so multiple inheritance, in sense multiple base classes and a single derived class. For that derived class we have to create the object, and with use of that object we can able to access all the base class methods as well as the derived class method. Okay, now let's move for hierarchical inheritance. So hierarchical inheritance is reverse of multiple inheritance. In multiple inheritance, what we will tell, we will have multiple base classes and a single derived class. But in hierarchical inheritance, we are having single base class and multiple derived class. So that is the structure of hierarchical inheritance. So what we have to do, we have to create derived class, multiple derived class for the single base class. How many derived classes you are creating? For every derived class, we have to create object to access the base class method as well as that particular derived class method. Okay, so let's see how the program will be written for hierarchical inheritance. So hierarchical inheritance, we are having the base class. So inside the base class we are having base one method. So inside the base one we are just displaying the statement as inside base one class method we are displaying. So we are creating the first derived class. Our derived class name is derived one. So inside derived one we are having derived one method. So what we are displaying inside the derived one class method, we are displaying as a output. Next to that we are having derived two. So derived two method we are having. So what we are displaying actually inside derived two class method, we are displaying as output. Third, what we are having, we are having derived three class. Derived three class we are just having derived three method. So we are just displaying inside derived three class method. You can see the common thing, derived one class also inherits base class, derived two class also inherits base class, and derived three class also inherits the base class. So we are having a single base class. All the three derived classes inherits the base class. So that I told, there is a single base class and multiple derived classes. All the derived classes will inherit the single base class. Okay, so that what we are telling hierarchical inheritance. Now we have three derived classes, so I have to create object for all the three derived classes. I am creating object 1 for derived 1, object 2 for derived 2, and object 3 for derived 3. Okay, so in this case what I am getting actually, I am just accessing obj1 dot derived 1 underscore method, obj2 dot derived 2 underscore method, and obj3 dot derived 3 underscore method. So derived 1 I can able to use, and with use of obj1 I can able to call the base class method as well as derived class method. Here I can able to give obj1 dot base class method. You can able to see the base class method also coming here. So I can able to access the base class method with use of obj1 as well as the derived class, the first derived class, whatever the derived class I created, that also I can able to access with use of obj1. The same thing, I can able to access the base class method with use of obj2. You can able to see the base class method is coming here. So I can able to access base class method, base1 underscore method with use of obj2 as well as derived2 method, derived class 2 method I can able to access with use of obj2. The same way I can able to access with use of obj3 dot I am giving, so here base method I can able to access. So with all the three objects I can able to access the base class method as well as its own derived class method I can able to access. Okay, so this is said to be hierarchical inheritance. This is said to be hierarchical inheritance. So when we are coming to hybrid inheritance will be the combination of any two types of inheritance. So any two types of inheritance mean by what? Here we are merging the hierarchical inheritance and the multiple inheritance. So hierarchical inheritance having one base class and two derived classes, and multiple inheritance having two base class and one derived class. Like that you can imagine a diagram. So one base class, down to that two derived classes, again down to that a single derived class. So this type of structure will be come under hierarchical inheritance, sorry, hybrid inheritance. So combination of any two or three inheritance type is come under hybrid inheritance. Okay, so what we are doing here, we are creating the base class. So in the base class, we are having a method, base method, and we are displaying inside base class method. And down to that, we are creating the first grade class that extends the base class, that inherits the base class. So here we are writing the derived one method, and we are just displaying inside the derived one class method we are displaying. And next to that, we are having derived two. So derived two, what we are having, we are just accessing the base class in the derived two. We are just inheriting the base class in the derived two, and we are just displaying the inside derived two class method inside derived two class method that is said to be derived two underscore method. Inside that, we are just displaying the statement as inside derived two class method. Next to that, we are having derived three. So derived three will be the most derived class, the last one. There we are inheriting derived one and derived two. So that we are giving derived one comma derived two. So inside that, we are just displaying, we are having a method named as derived three underscore method. So that we are displaying the statement as inside derived three class method. Okay, so we have to create object for the last class that is said to be derived three. With use of derived three object, we can able to access the base class method. So obj dot base method I am accessing, then obj dot derived one method I am accessing, then obj dot derived two method I am accessing. Finally, I am accessing obj dot derived three. So you can see at last, you can see the last one, that is obj dot derived three also I wrote here. So this the way we can able to do the hybrid inheritance. So here the base derived one derived two, if you are taking, that will be come under hierarchical inheritance. Derived two, derived two, derived three, if you are taking, that will be come under multiple inheritance. So this two combination we are making as hybrid inheritance. Okay, so let's see the output for all the programs. I will execute one by one. So here I am executing the single inheritance. So I am accessing the base and derived class methods. So let's see what the output we are getting. So you can able to see the inside base class method and inside derived class method, both we are getting as output here when we are executing the single inheritance. So single inheritance, as I told, it will access the base class method and derived class method. With use of derived class object, we are accessing both. Now when we are going for multi-level inheritance, what we are doing, we are just having a chain relation. So base will be accessed by derived one, derived one will be accessed by derived two, so that we are creating object for derived two. So with use of derived two object, we are calling the base method, derived one method, and derived two method. So let's see the output for this particular code, and we will get the output for all the three particular classes. So here inside base class method we are getting as output. Next to that, we are getting inside derived one class method we are getting, and then inside derived two class method we are getting. So this three statements we are getting as output. Okay, then next to that, multiple inheritance we are having. Multiple inheritance, what is mean by multiple inheritance? So multiple base classes and a single derived class. So that we are having three base classes and a single derived class, in that we are inheriting base 1, base 2, base 3, and we are creating object for the derived class. With use of the derived class object, what we are doing, we are calling the base class method, that is base 1 method, then base 2 method, base 3 method, and then derived class method. So all the four methods we are accessing with use of a single object, that is said to be the derived class object. So let's execute this code and see the output for this particular code. So you can able to see the output. We are accessing all the four methods. First one is inside base 1 class method, inside base 2 class method, and inside base 3 class method. Inside derived class method we are having, so that we will get the output like this. Next, hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance mean by what? We have a single base class and multiple derived classes. So our base class name is base, and we are having derived 1, derived 2, derived 3, three derived classes. And for every derived class, we have to create object. With use of object 1, the first derived class object, we are accessing the base class method as well as the derived 1 class method, that is derived 1 underscore method. And with use of obj 2, that is derived 2 class object, we are just calling base class method as well as derived 2 class method. And then the third one, obj 3, what we are doing, obj 3 dot base 1 method, and the same obj3 we are using for calling the derived 3 class method. So let's execute this particular program for hierarchical inheritance and see the output. So here we will get the output like this. You can able to see the output. So inside base 1 class method, derived 1 class method. So this is using obj1 we are calling. Second output what we are getting here, inside base1 class method, inside derived2 class method. This is using obj2. Obj2, the second object we are using to call this particular thing. And the third one we are using for obj3. Obj3 we are using, no? There we are getting the output as inside base1 class method and inside derived3 class method we are getting as output. Okay, I hope you understand this particular thing. Let's move for the hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance, as I told, the combination of any two types of inheritance. So here we are having single base class and derived class and derived 1 and derived 2. This will be the type of hierarchical inheritance. And when you are seeing this derived 1, derived 2, derived 3, in that way we can able to see multiple inheritance. Both combining, we are taking up this hybrid inheritance. So in this hybrid inheritance, we are creating object for derived 3. So derived 3, we are having the object name as obj. So with use of obj, we are calling the base class method, derived 1 method, derived 2 method, and derived 3 method. So that what the output we are getting, let's see the output here. While executing this particular program, what the output we are getting, here we will get the output. You can able to see the output. Here we are getting the output as inside base class method, that is for the calling base class from derived 3 object. We are creating object for the derived 3, but with use of that derived 3 object, we are calling the base class method, so that we got the output as inside base class method. Next to that, we are having derived 1 class method as output. That will be inside the method of derived 1 method. So this statement will be displayed. And then derived 2, we are getting derived 2 class method, and derived 3, we are getting inside derived 3 class method. Okay, so this what we are getting the output for all the five types of inheritance. So inheritance is very important in Python programming or any object oriented concepts. So I hope you understand this particular point. You can execute this program from your end with use of your own laptop or PC, so that you can able to understand this particular programmings. Okay, so subscribe, share and support. Thank you very much. Like my videos, and you can comment my videos if you are interested in any topic. You can put in the comment line, so that I will produce good videos in that particular topics. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching my video.